Alright, what's up? Today I'm going to be talking about a sports injury known as jumper's knee. Basically, it is patellar tendonitis. It's basically you have this tendon right here that is connected to your quadricep, and about 20% of athletes get it. What it's caused by is a weakness in your inner quadricep right here. And your quadricep has, you know, four different muscles. Well, the one right in the inner, it's going to affect your outer, the outside of your patellar tendon connecting to your tibia. So I have this injury right now. I have had it and gotten rid of it before, basically just with time. But, you know, there are other ways to make it go by faster. So basically what I'm going to talk about is a way to, once you have it, a way to make it heal faster. And then I'm going to talk about prevention. Okay, so once you have it, so I have it in this knee right now, and a little bit in this knee, it's almost healed, but it's a lot stronger now. What you want to do is you want to stretch the affected muscles and tendons. So doing a quadricep stretch like this will help you just loosen it up. Tendons have low vascularity, so they don't heal so fast. So if you can get blood flowing in that area, it's good. It's gonna heal a little faster. Okay, yeah, so stretch your quads and your patellar tendon. The next thing is ice it. So what you want to do is 20 minutes of icing in the affected area, so right below the kneecap onto the tibia, ice it for 20 minutes and then let it go for a couple hours, and then, you know, 2-3 hours, and then after that you want to put heat on it, and then you want to cycle that. You want to, you know, a couple hours later put ice on it, and then a couple hours later put heat on it. That's going to help it, you know, stop the inflammation. It's going to help it heal a little bit faster. Other things you could do is also massage it. Just like I said, low vascularity, it gets the blood in there. Okay, so here are some exercises that are going to help you strengthen your patellar tendon. All right? So we're going to start off with some squats. This is an NASM recommended exercise for patellar tendonitis, alright? Okay, so basically, just squat. You know, come until your knees are 90 degrees, and bring it back up. It's basically like you're sitting flat. Bring it back up. Do that about 20 times. You do that about 20 times, 3 sets of 20, and then, you know, rest. Take 1 minute breaks in between. Okay, so our next one is going to be an eccentric drop squat. Now, you may have seen other videos other videos showing this as well. Basically, you want to have a chair or something that you can fall back onto, and with your affected knee, you're gonna squat. And you're just going to squat down. You're not going to squat back up. You're going to fall into the chair. So you raise your unaffected knee, and then you just squat down. So you raise your unaffected knee, squat down. All right? And if your knees aren't that bad, you can actually bring yourself up. All right? So, other foot, squat down, bring myself back up, squat down, bring myself back up. Okay? Okay, so there's one more exercise I'd like to show you. It's going to strengthen your inner quadricep. Basically, what you do is a leg lift. So you're going to want to point your toes kind of outward, and you're gonna straighten your legs so that your inner quadricep is tightened, You're going to lift and hold it and let down. You're going to lift and hold it and let it down. You're going to lift, hold it, let down. Lift, hold it, let down. Okay, so in review, we had the squats. We had the one-legged drop squats. And now we have the leg lifts. Okay? Now, what is going to help you prevent injury? Of course, warming up beforehand so that your tendons aren't tight and, you know, cold and tight and easily injured. Also, stretching, fully stretching your quadriceps, your hamstrings, your calf muscles, and every other, you know, muscle in the area, you know, down here, everything like that in your feet and legs. Every muscle in your leg is connected, you know what I mean? So you want to have proper technique when you're jumping. Another thing that can help prevent getting jumper's knee is strengthening the muscles on your shins. This also helps to prevent shin splints when running as well. So basically what you want to do is when you're standing, you want to, you know, stand straight and lift your toes. Toe lifts. You're gonna have your heel is gonna stay on the ground. You're gonna feel this muscle tensing. You're gonna tense this muscle. That's gonna strengthen it. That's gonna help strengthen this entire area, this entire front of the tibia, and as well as balance out the strength of your calf muscles that might give you shin splints. So in review, we've talked about what kind of prevention we can do, what kind of exercises we can do, and what kind of treatments we can do for patellar tendonitis.